How did you come to take up boxing?
Well, I started about 6 years ago. My bicycle was stolen, and my cousin was a boxer. He wasn't too successful, but he boxed. And he told me that he would train me if I ever catch the guy that, you know how kids think, if I ever caught the guy that stole my bicycle, well, he would, I would know how to fight. You know, I could defend myself. Well, anyway, he took me to the gym, and he quit later, but I kept it up.
Did you catch the guy who stole your bike?
No, I never did.
You still looking for him?
No.
We know what led to him becoming the greatest. But it's what made him the greatest that forever changed the world. God allows things to happen in our life that shapes us, or at the very least, presents us with the opportunity to make a decision that will move us forward or backwards. Ali's bike was stolen when he was 12 years old, and it was this event that spearheaded the life of a man that changed the world in so many ways. As an athlete, as a black man, and as a person that sought righteousness and justice for all people of the world, especially his black brothers and sisters, which suffered from so much inequality and injustices because of the color of their skin. Muhammad Ali's path to greatness in the ring began as a teenage phenom, winning AAU championships and Golden Glove titles, turning pro shortly after, and setting the road to a heavyweight championship opportunity. In 1964, at 22 years old, Ali, then known as Cassius Clay, defeated Sonny Liston in Miami, Florida to become the heavyweight champion of the world. Instantly thrust into the world spotlight, Clay, a man of many words and facts, realized the opportunity he had to become much more than a boxer.
There's great interest in the fact that you have joined the Muslim religion. How long have you had this interest, Cassius?
Oh, for the past 6 years, I would say, after hearing a lot of teachings on Negro history and who we were before we got here. And one in one makes two.
Do you feel your affiliation with the Muslim religion, being a follower of the Muslim religion, had something to do with your winning the championship?
After winning the title, Clay publicly announced that he was a member of the Nation of Islam and would no longer be using the name Cassius Clay, but from then on be Muhammad Ali. This timing could not have been more perfect. Ali, a world champion fighter, and also a black man in the most racist country in the world, stood up for something that held more weight in his eyes than any title or amount of money could buy: his religion, integrity, and personal beliefs. Ali could have easily practiced his religion unbeknownst to the public and been loved by his oppressors outwardly and enjoyed the riches and notoriety that came with celebrity. But Ali realized that these essentially material things and opportunities would not benefit him or his people. His friendship with Malcolm X was something that furthermore gave him a black eye in the United States of America. Malcolm, being a person of integrity, principle, and also seeking righteousness for black Americans. But this fact was irrelevant to the champ. The hate that these two encountered together was outweighed by the intrigue and respect that these two iconic black men received on a world level, which is even of a larger magnitude in 2016.
The image of the American Negro as someone with no confidence, no militancy, and they had done this by giving him images of heroes that weren't truly militant or confident. And now here come Cassius, the exact contrast of everything that was representative of the Negro image. He said he was the greatest. All of the odds were against him. He upset the odds makers. He won. He became victorious. He became the champ. They knew that as soon as, if people began to identify with Cassius and the type of image he was creating, they were going to have trouble out of these Negroes, because they'd have Negroes walking around the street saying, "I'm the greatest."
Publicly proclaiming his faith in a country that considered him a second-class citizen despite being the heavyweight champion of the world simply because of the color of his skin was his first step into greatness.
I haven't burned my own draft record, but what I'm doing is legal. This is why I believe I'll receive justice in the higher court. You can deny the draft on any grounds, but you'll have to go to court. It's law. If you lose, you go to jail, which I said I'd do. My fight is legal. But if you notice, I'm being the most persecuted. I'm not allowed to work in America. I'm not allowed to leave America. Home of the brave, land of the free. Not even allowed to leave where I can work. Countries that will accept me. And now I'm due $10,000 fine in 5 years. All this brings on racial trouble. People see this.
First of all, I would like to thank the student governing body for inviting me here to speak at this.
Refusing to go across the world to fight for a country that didn't give him his rights and liberties promised in its laws to all citizens, being nothing more than a nigger with money to the majority of non-black citizens in the country he lived in, and stepping into another country to carry out doctrines of hate levied against him by the same country against another country that had never mistreated him, or, in his exact words, "No Viet Cong ever called me nigger." This is where Muhammad Ali forever became the greatest.
Into the United States Army, especially as some have pointed out, many have pointed out, when not taking the step, I will lose so much. And I would like to say to those of the press and those of the people who think that I lost so much by not taking the step, I would like to say that I did not lose a thing up until this very moment. I haven't lost one thing.
Great people, great leaders, become great because of humility, integrity, and sacrifice. Ali was the heavyweight champion of the world, rich, and could basically go anywhere he pleased. Standing up for right, standing up for what he believed, caused him to instantly lose everything he earned through hard work. Boxing commissions revoked his license to box nationwide. He was stripped of the heavyweight title, and the United States of America stripped Ali of his passport, thus eliminating his opportunity to make a living internationally. On top of these farcical actions taken by the United States of America, he was sentenced to 5 years in prison and fined $10,000. From March 1967 to October 1970, Ali did not fight opponents. He fought the system. He fought the racist ideas and systematic oppression of the darker colored people in the United States of America. He fought for his right to live as a free citizen in this country, his right to make a living in this country. It was during this time that Ali, along with other superstar black athletes and prominent black figures, came together to stand for something bigger than sports, bigger than themselves. Bill Russell, Lew Cinder, and Jim Brown, the most famous athletes in their respective sports, came together to support Ali, knowing the perceived consequences which they may encounter. But this didn't matter. Stand for something or fall for anything.
Who finds this war objectionable and abominable and unjust, but file as a conscientious objector. And no matter what you think of Mr. Muhammad Ali's religion, you certainly have to admire his courage.
Et sa grande satisfaction, c'est de savoir qu'il n'est toujours pas oublié.
Nigeria, the Sudan, I get a lot of mail.
From the years of 1967 to 1970, two people who were major proponents for change and justice were assassinated. Robert Kennedy, the brother of President John F. Kennedy, who was assassinated in 1963, and Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who was assassinated in 1968, leaving a gaping hole in the spectrum of a voice of reason. The total opposite of the stereotypes that were created and existed about black men at the time. Muhammad Ali, the people's champ, was the total opposite. A beautiful black man, an articulate black man, a man that understood his obligation is not only a black man to help elevate his oppressed people, but to also enlighten the masses, which didn't fully understand what was going on in America, and particularly with black Americans. Having his conviction overturned in 1971, Ali regained his licenses to box. It was then that he wrote history athletically, becoming the first boxer to become a three-time heavyweight champion of the world. The People's Champ regained the world championship by defeating George Foreman in 1974 in the Rumble in the Jungle in Zaire, Africa, and then again in 1978 defeating Leon Spinks at the Superdome in New Orleans, Louisiana. These feats in the ring, as great as they were, paled in comparison to the world figure Ali had become. His consistency as a man of principle in regard to standing for something larger than himself is what the world embraced. An uncommon man, living his life as a common man, allowed Muhammad Ali to connect with people all over the world.
You see me do this, you call me the greatest, that's because I'm more religious than I am physical, and I study a lot. And you may be surprised if you hear me talk, because you never heard me talk this way. But I know about, I got about 45 lectures that I memorized in my ministry, and I can tell you something about all the religious books, all the religions, because I have a strong belief in God and humanity. That's why I'm helping these boys. That's why God blesses me to be so great here, because all the time I've been here, I've been talking about God, pushing religion. I'm not talking about me, how great I am, how much money I got. I'm always giving the praise to God. So that's why I'm as great as I am in this physical world, because I push him first.
Muhammad Ali changed the sport of boxing forever. Muhammad Ali changed the world forever. In both instances, there was one consistency: authenticity. Ali changed the sport of boxing with his own unique style that went against traditionalists. He changed the world, specifically the perception in America of the black man, the black athlete, with his authenticity to be himself. Stay 100% true to his beliefs that also went against traditionalist. For these things, we thank you, Muhammad Ali. For these things, you are the world's greatest.